In this video, we're going to look at order of operations using negative numbers. The order of operations is the same with negative numbers as with positive numbers. You do all operations inside parentheses first, then you do all exponent operations from left to right, then we do all dividing and multiplying from left to right, and then finally we do all adding and subtracting from left to right. We'll illustrate this with some examples. First, we're going to evaluate negative 2 minus 4 times 2 plus negative 1 squared. The first thing we do to evaluate this expression is the exponent operation of negative 1 squared. Negative 1 squared is negative 1 times negative 1, which is positive 1. So this becomes negative 2 minus 4 times 2 plus positive 1. Next, we do the multiply before we add or subtract. 4 times 2 is 8, so we have negative 2 minus 8 plus 1. Then we add subtract from left to right, and I'm going to rewrite that subtraction as the addition of a negative. And then we're going to add negative 2 plus negative 8, and that makes negative 10. And then that gives us negative 10 plus 1, and negative 10 added to 1 is negative 9, which is our answer. In the next example, we're going to divide 40 by negative 5, subtract the quantity 2 minus 5 cubed, and then subtract 3 squared. Well, our order of operations says to do that 2 minus 5 first, and that becomes negative 3. Now we take the exponent operation next. We do the negative 3 to the third power, and that's negative 3 times negative 3 times negative 3, which becomes a negative 27. And always remember that when you take an odd power of a negative, you get a negative answer. Now we have a divide and two subtracts. So we do the divide first. We do the 40 divide by negative 5 before we do any subtractions. 40 divided by negative 5 is negative 8. Because remember, a positive divided by a negative gives you a negative answer. Now we add subtract from left to right. Negative 8 plus 27 is positive 19. 19 minus the 9 gives us 10 as our answer. Now we're going to look at an example where we evaluate an expression that has variables in it. We're going to evaluate a minus b squared plus the quantity c minus d quantity squared, where a equals 2, b equals negative 3, C equals negative 1, and D equals 4. The first step here is to replace each variable with its numerical equivalent. We replace A with 2, B with negative 3, we replace C with negative 1, and D with 4. So we get the expression 2 minus the quantity negative 3 squared plus negative 1 minus 4 quantity squared. According to our order of operations, we do the operations inside the parentheses first. We do the negative 1 minus 4 first, and that gives us negative 5. Now we have a subtraction and an addition and two squaring operations. We do the two squaring operations before we do anything. We do negative 3 squared, and that's positive 9. We still have the minus out in front of it. We haven't changed that. The negative 5 squared is positive 25. Remember, two negatives multiplied together makes a positive. Now we have a subtraction and an addition. We do those from left to right. 2 minus 9 is the same as 2 plus negative 9. That makes negative 7. We add that to 25, and that gives us an answer of 18. In this last example, we're going to evaluate 1 minus 4 times 2 minus the quantity 2 minus 3 squared quantity squared times negative 1. This is sort of a challenging problem, but see if you can follow along. We have a whole bunch of operations. The first thing we do are the operations inside the parentheses, and that's 2 minus 3 squared. Well, within those operations, the first thing we do is the 3 squared, because that takes precedence over subtraction. And 3 squared is 3 times 3, or just 9. So now we have 2 minus 9 inside those parentheses. That's the same as 2 plus negative 9, and that makes negative 7. Okay, now we have a subtraction, a multiplication, a subtraction, a squaring operation, and then multiplying by negative 1. Well, we do our squaring first. Negative 7 squared is positive 49. We still have the minus out in front of it. And now that leaves us with two subtractions and two multiplies. We do the two multiplies first. 4 times 2 makes 8. It's still minus in front of it. We haven't changed that. And the 49 times negative 1 is negative 49. And again, we still have a minus in front of that. Now we subtract from left to right. 1 minus 8 is negative 7. That's minus a negative 49. I'm going to rewrite that as negative 7 plus 49. And that gives us an answer of 42. This is a challenging problem. Maybe you should try this on your own to see if you can get this answer.